In this case, like in many other cases, there's not just a single right answer, because you can build many test cases that will satisfy this test specification. So for example, we could pick value 3 for A and value 9 for B. Those satisfy the specification because A plus B is equal to 12 and therefore is greater than 0. And therefore, this is a test case that implements this test specification. And in terms of results, what we expect to see is, in the case of a result greater than 0, the color should be red and the output value should be 12. Analogously, for this test specification, we just need to pick two inputs such that the sum of the two inputs is less than 0. So for example, we could pick minus 5 and minus 8. The output color in this case is going to be blue, and the output value is going to be minus 13. So what we just saw is basically how we can go from a piece of code to a set of requirements, which are the interesting aspects of the code that we want to exercise, how we can satisfy the requirements by finding the right test specifications, and then how we can instantiate these test specifications into actual test cases. And this is what we will do in general when doing white box testing. And we'll do it in a slightly different way depending on the specific criteria that we are considering.